Hello, Science Matters kids. This is Lesson 5, Potential and Kinetic Energy. Today we're going to learn about energy. The world is full of energy. There are many different types of energy, such as light, heat, sound, elastic, potential, kinetic, and oh so many more. We can define a certain system, and the total energy of this defined system always remains constant. The energy might change forms, but the total overall energy remains constant. Potential energy is stored energy. Gravitational potential energy is stored based on height above the ground. And elastic potential energy is stored in the bonds of stretchy materials that are stretched and stressed. Kinetic energy is the energy of motion or moving. Most objects gain potential energy that is then converted into kinetic energy, as an object takes this energy to move. When a rubber band is stretched, it gains elastic potential energy that can be converted into kinetic energy, as the rubber band is released and moves through the air. Bouncy balls, wind-up toys, dart guns, and Olympic divers, to name a few, all convert stored potential energy into the kinetic energy of motion as they go from rest to moving through the air. We are going to learn all about energy. So let's start our first lesson. Our first lesson is called Knows Potential. We are going to observe and explain that the ball loses potential energy as it gains kinetic energy, as the total energy stays constant. For us to start this experiment, we're going to need a few materials. We're going to need a wooden dowel rod, a tennis ball, duct tape, and cotton string. So, our first step is to wrap one end of the string around the tennis ball and secure tightly to the ball with duct tape. Then, tie the other end of the string to the wooden dowel rod. Hold the dowel rod securely to an object in the classroom that is about 4 to 5 feet high, or have two students hold the rod above the ground. Next, let the ball drop and hang vertically near the floor. Our next step after this is to have one student sit on the floor about 3 to 5 feet away from the ball, with their back against a wall or solid object that will not move. Hand the ball to the student, making sure the string is tight. Have the student scoot forward or move the dowel rod so that the string is tight. Make sure the students understand to hold the ball so that it just touches their nose. Let go of the ball and do not move. The ball will swing away from the student and come back, stopping right in front of their nose. Go ahead and have all the students try. So, was anybody scared that the tennis ball was going to come back and hit them in the nose? I was the first time I tried this, until I learned that as long as you drop the ball and nobody else pushes it while it's swinging, then the total energy of the ball and the string can never be greater than the energy it had when it started, which was determined by the place you let it go, right in front of your nose. The ball will come back to your nose, but not past it. Right before you let the ball go, it had lots of potential energy, based on you pulling it back and how high above the ground it was. When you let it go, it began to move and transferred the potential energy into kinetic energy, the energy of motion. Once the ball got back to the straight up and down position, it had only kinetic energy. As the ball began to swing up to the other side, the kinetic energy went down and the potential energy went up. The important part is, even though the energy kept changing between potential and kinetic energy as the ball swung back and forth, the total energy stayed the same. This means that as the kinetic energy got bigger, the potential energy had to get smaller so that the total energy stayed the same. Let's try another experiment with kinetic energy. Our next lesson is called The Hopper. We are going to observe that the rubber band gains elastic potential energy as it is stretched, and this potential energy can be converted into kinetic energy of the hopper as the straw is released, causing the straw to fly into the air. some of the materials you're going to need are going to be a straw, a small bamboo skewer, a rubber band, and a roll of duct tape. Before we begin, cut each rubber band so that it becomes one long strip of stretchy rubber band. Trim off any points from each bamboo skewer. We don't want anyone to get hurt. Make sure the bamboo skewer is between 2 to 3 inches longer than the straw. Trim any straws if needed. Go ahead and pass out one straw, one cut rubber band, and one strip of pre-cut duct tape for each scholar. The scholars have to slide the cut rubber band over one end of the straw with equal amounts of rubber band on each side of the straw. Grab the rubber band that is covering the opening of the straw and pull it back to create about a half inch space between the rubber band and the opening of the straw, keeping equal amounts of rubber band on each side of the straw. Secure the rubber band in place with the strip of duct tape. Wrap the duct tape tightly around the straw, keeping the rubber band separated on both sides of the straw. Pass out one bamboo skewer per scholar and instruct them to slide the bamboo skewer into the open end of the straw and push until it reaches the rubber band at the other end of the straw. To make the hopper hop, hold the bamboo skewer inside the straw vertically on the table and pull down on the straw until the straw touches the table, stretching the rubber band. Quickly let go of the straw. The straw and the rubber band combo should hop into the air while the bamboo skewer stays on the table. Your hopper jumps into the air because the rubber band is stretched and gains elastic potential energy. When you let go of the straw, the rubber band pushes off the bamboo skewer and converts it into stored elastic potential energy into kinetic energy of moving as the straw flies into the air. Let's build another device that converts elastic potential energy into kinetic energy as something shoots across the room. Our last lesson is the ping pong blaster. We are going to observe that the rubber band gains elastic potential energy as it is stretched, and this potential energy can be converted into kinetic energy of the ball as the rubber band is released, causing the ball to fly into the air. The materials you're going to need for this lesson are going to be one cardboard tube. If you don't have a thicker piece of cardboard tubing, go ahead and take two toilet paper rolls and stuff one inside the other. This will be strong enough for what we're trying to do. You will also need a ping pong ball or a smaller rubber band ball, four rubber bands, four paper clips, and a roll of duct tape. To begin, tie one rubber band together at the ends to create one rubber band that is approximately twice as long as the original rubber band. Go ahead and pass out one cardboard tube, two paper clips, and one long tied together rubber band to each scholar. The scholars need to hook one end of the rubber band to one paper clip and the other to the second paper clip. Attach one paper clip over the side of the cardboard tube on one end of the tube. Stretch the rubber band and attach the other paper clip to the tube on the same end but opposite side of the first paper clip. Repeat with the other rubber band and two more paper clips. The tube should have all four paper clips on one end, evenly spaced, and the two rubber bands crossing in an X over the other end. The four paper clips should be hooked on the same end of the tube, and if the tube opening were a clock face, be spaced at 3, 6, 9, and 12 o'clock. The rubber band should cross over each other over the open end of the tube, opposite from the paper clips. Wrap a long piece of duct tape over the paper clips to hold them in place. To fire the ping pong blaster, hold the tube so that the open end, the end with the paper clips, is facing up at approximately 45 degrees. Slide a ping pong ball into the tube. Pull back on the crossed rubber bands and release. make sure not to fire the ping pong ball at the other students. Alright, let's bring it all back together. I don't know about you, but I am tired after gaining and losing all kinds of energy today. Remember, the total energy of a system stays the same, but changes form from potential energy to kinetic energy, and back and forth and back and forth and on and on. When something is lifted above the ground, it gains gravitational potential energy. And when a rubber band or stretchy material is stretched out, it gains elastic potential energy. When this energy is given to an object, the object begins to move as it gains kinetic energy, which is the energy of moving. I hope you had as much fun as I did over the past few weeks, as we explore many different branches of science in Super Science Smorgasbord. Have fun with all the cool things that we have made, and keep amazing your family and friends with all the awesome magic tricks and illusions. Remember, science is never magic, but magic is usually science. Also, your hopper and ping pong blaster are not weapons. Make sure you use them in the proper way, and be safe and careful.